roughly half an hour, depending on the quality of the questions. I'm going to answer questions from the chat, and I have a few things I need to talk about first. Obviously, the whole company is on vacation, so it's only me and a few other guys at the office at the moment, but we'll see if we can get through it. A lot of you guys have been asking for an update on the RTS refactoring, and what I've been told now is that the important bits have been moved to our development server and merged to the development server, and is currently being tested. So hopefully that part will soon be ready. It's the way we produce stuff in here. It's like a major change, like the RTS refactoring. It goes on a different, you could say, a different working environment, and the changes there need to be moved onto the main development environment in order not to mess things up. And that's kind of a complex process to do that, unfortunately. But we're working on it, don't worry. Then there is some annoyance with the RTS. The unit productions are too low. We have reduced the size or the capacity of the assault teams instead of buffing the number of resources, and that's currently in test. We might also need to up the production rate, but obviously, everybody being on holiday, we haven't been able to adjust any of this stuff the last few weeks, but we're going to continue looking into it. And then there's the skilled matchmaker status that you guys want to know something about. The skilled matchmaker, the algorithm is currently running on live, so we're collecting data from the matchmaking algorithm right now. And until then, the old skilled matchmaker have been switched on, which is not working as well as the new stuff is supposed to do. So it's also in the works. And then I can, I need to tell you, some of you guys actually already know, but we put up two new game modes based on the tank versus tank game mode onto Prototype. And currently, you can just go in there and play them. That's one of them is Recon versus Recon, same kind of rules, and Plane versus Plane. So if you want to try something new, go in there and check it out. We will start to gather feedback on those game modes next week, I assume, as soon as people are back from holiday. So let's see if you guys can give me some questions in the chat. Remember to mark my name in there, otherwise I can't see what is questions and what is just general chattiness. And we have the first question here from Dr. Hoops, is asking about the squad linking. We need squad linking. When we get that done? We actually have it done, but we parked it on a separate stream because it seemed like a very easy way to do the linking, just link two squads together. But when we started to test it, it just introduced so many weird edge cases and cases that we hadn't thought about. So we just actually ended up saying, this stuff needs to, we can't release it. There's just way too many bugs in it or way too many unfortunate effects of it. So it's actually been parked at the moment, and I can't say when we will pick it up again and see if we can wrap it up. So that's actually not so good news for you guys who want it. Then we have Freeman O'Limit is asking question for the RTS. Why first develop is not instant, and then we want to refill, redeploy, we go into the queue, frustrating to not use our assault teams we have fought for in the game. Why first deploy is not instant is because there's a great difference between the amount of assault teams on each faction, which would lead to probably Germany being way overpowered in the game. So we need some sort of a limit here on this, on the resources, especially in the beginning. So that's the reason for not just having everybody deploy. We are considering having the account-based deploy system in place instead, because that would make it a bit more fair. There are some players who have a lot of assault teams, and those assault teams will be queued up in large chunks. So like one player might be getting a lot of his assault teams deployed, and a lot of other players might not get their assault teams deployed, which is kind of unfair. So then there's the Juggernaut 9631. What's up with armor plates? Nobody likes them, and they are on hold at the moment. Will you add them or no? Please don't. yeah, I haven't had time to read the latest feedback report from the community, but it does seem like it's one of those things that we probably need to not deploy, simply because it seems to be it creates so much bad tension. So that's a shame, I think. But I have a better answer for that in next week when people are back from vacation, and we can have a proper discussion about it. Matt Airborne is asking when we will see the Fortress map on the live servers. When it's done. Currently, we slow down the development of it because we have put a little bit of more focus into bug fixing the old maps. There's a ton of like places you get stuck with the vehicles and errors with the terrain and stuff. So we actually spend some time fixing those bugs instead of working on the new map. So that's the explanation for the Fortress map being on hold at the moment, or not at the hold. We have some guys working on it. What is that name? Levidoists Twitch. I just love these names. Can we get a more detailed update on the progress of the Fortress map? I just gave that. We're not fully working on it at the moment. Then we have the Lycan 77. Do you understand that the game is buggy mess right now, and that you should focus on fixing all said bugs and issues before you add anything else that will more likely make it more of a buggy mess? Well, as I said before, we switched our focus to fixing bugs on the maps instead of making new maps. So I hear you. Then there's FM HNG. We need a clan system. True that. And then we have Logro Archicor. I need somebody else to. Maybe I should put in on like an auto vocal or something, so the computer can speak the names instead of me. Why put the M8 Greyhound on tier 2 and introduce why not? I guess it should be why not put M8 Greyhound on tier 2 and introduce the Staghound to tier 3 recon car. Greyhound needs buff. It's still placed on tier 3. It only has 37 millimeter and it's open top turret. Yeah, this might not be remembering correctly, but I think the Staghound is actually a British vehicle. Let me see if I can find it here on Wikipedia. No. It is a US vehicle. It's cool. It never saw service with frontline US forces, but was supplied to the US United Kingdom. So yeah, it was used by the UK. That might be why we're not using it. I would have to get back to Cristiano on that, if that answers your question. So we have Alien 31 ITA is asking, when will your game be community friendly by doing custom maps and games? Well, because the game is, one of the reasons is that the game is running on a custom engine, which means that creating maps is not super easy to do. The maps are built using a combination of internal tools and Exercise Softimage, which is a commercial 3D package. So it would be fairly expensive for players to create their own things, their own maps. And on top of that, we simply don't have the capacity to support that the community would be able to build their own maps. So that would be the answer for that. Obviously, I'd love to see some player generated maps. That would be awesome, but it's simply too difficult for us to do, or to open that part up. Let's see the next one here. Dark Hill 18? Is there any work on balancing tank rolls out and even balance the tank damage taken with armor comparison? What do you think that means? Tank rolls? Is it the. I don't really think I understand the question, other than. There might be some imbalancing, or what, on the damage. Well, every time we spot some imbalances, we try to adjust it. That's basically what I can say. But it's it needs to be something that's obvious to a lot of players before we take action on it, and not just one player say, yeah, this part should be weaker or better or whatever, because when we start to add all that feedback up, usually it's there's so many who thinks that you should either buff something or nerf something, and it's kind of like it's not that easy to just it's not as like a set calculation. It's also about how you actually play the different vehicles or the different tanks. Then there's the Sanos Kick is asking, what will happen to armor plates? Well, I can say that next week, when we've had a chance to discuss it, it seems that there's still a lot of the players, a lot of you guys, who are unhappy about it. So we need to take that into account. Then there's it. Yorkis. Hey, hello. I have a question about assist kills. Are you planning on fixing the kill assisting system with planes and tanks? For example, I destroyed 90% of an enemy aircraft and a teammate finished him off, and I get no kill assist. Same with tanks. Are you going to do something about it? I would just make a single hit and assist if somebody finishes the prey off. Good luck. I think maybe we should take a look at, see if we can adjust the system to be a little bit more fair. But it's always difficult with the kill assist on in these things where you can actually grind it down an enemy, and then the other guy gets the kill. What if the could say, like, what if the killing shot is actually a headshot, for example? How do you divide those two up? That would be a kill shot in its own right, for example, rather than an assist shot. So it's not completely easy to do a system that doesn't have situations where it might seem unfair. And there's a Rikje 99. For what class are the silence guns that are currently on hold? That's the recon class. I know that. And I can also say that the I think we're still Cristiano right now is working on scopes, new scopes for infantry, so we can and we will at this point replace all the infantry scopes with these new infantry dedicated scopes, which are weaker than the current ones, because we want to make it more separate between the recon class and the infantry scopes. So and that would be viewed as a nerf to the infantry scopes. Then there's Challenger 303, me again. Will those British or Italians, etc., soldiers build still be added to existing factions to bring them in slowly, or is that idea scrapped now? No, that's not scrapped. That will be probably the best way to introduce a new faction would be to link it to an existing factions with just one class or one vehicle at a time, simply because that's it's like creating a whole new faction would be a lot of work. So, and we're not in that situation right now. So I think that would be like one class at a time linked to the existing class, existing factions. And this Food Chairman. What about the old 215 coastal map proposed a long time ago? Any new maps on the horizon? I think I can talk a little bit about the coastal map situation. We have discussed it. I think it would be nice to have a coastal map. Obviously, we need to do some tweaks to the map engine, because if you ever notice, the terrain actually repeats. So in order to make a coastal map, you have to have an ocean at one side and then terrain on the other side. But that should be a minor technical detail, but at least it needs to be done in order to make this specific type of map. But then there's a whole thing about the game flow on a map like that. If it have to work well in the strategy game, then you'd have to be able to attack from both sides. What happens when you it makes perfect sense that when you have the land or the seaside where you have people totally Omaha Beach style attacking from the ocean and capturing bunkers and stuff, then you capture the map in the RTS game. What happens if when the defenders now re-attack the map and you actually hold the map? I would not assume them to be attacking from the ocean side. They should be attacking from the land side. So we need to make sure that a map design can take this into account to make it work, like you said, like both ways. And I haven't really seen any of that yet. So maybe it should be an entirely new game mode instead of just the assault mode. I don't know, but at least it needs to work in both ways. And there's the Eisenheinrich, the German FG-42 for infantry for the Johnson on US side. Nope, I think I've said no to this 1,000 times already, so I'm just going to say it again. No. Then there's a K3 Sooty beer and candy review stream. When? We should do that next week then. I think we have currently we have a policy of not having beer on the stream, which is a shame, but that's the current policy. So maybe the candy then, but I'm not really into candy, so maybe it's gonna be Gargamel instead who's supposed to eat. Oh well, maybe Cristiano, he's really into candy. Then there's FM HNG again. We need a clan system. How long should we wait? Well, obviously, we are not that many people working on this, so the clan system would have to wait until something else is done. And obviously, we have a lot of bugs to fix before we can start figuring out what next to put into the game. And we have the refactor, and there's a lot of other things that's currently being worked on. Then there's James playing. Are you guys gonna add some sort of challenges to get rewards from them, like get 5 headshots or something and then get gold or credits from them. We do have some sort of a achievement system in the works, but again, it's not nearly near release. So then that would be kind of like what you're thinking about, I guess, like daily missions and stuff like that. So then we have Kaneki K. Are there bipods coming for snipers to reduce the scope sway? No, but we are looking into fixing the sway, the more the random sway on the sniper rifles. We were actually having a larger discussion regarding the armor plates and the heavy set and everything around this one shot discussion. And in that respect, we also discussed making the sniper rifles more predictable in their sway patterns, so they would it would be more like a skill to actually shoot rather than a random factor that we put on top of it. So that might actually happen in instead of bipods, we might actually do something with the sniper sway instead. Then there's Alien 31 ITA at the Sonderkraftfahrzeug 252 for recon and bring back 250 for infantry. Just a second. I need to figure out what this one is. That's cool. But why would you add the one back for? This is a command car. Maybe without the antenna, that would be made more sense. But the one we have right now is actually the scout version. So, but that's 252 is actually pretty cool. Bagevi, terrain fix when? Actually, right now the terrain on the I'm personally looking into the airfield map and making a ton of fixes on that one, because that seems to have been gone into a mutation state where a lot of weird shit is happening. And currently, I'm looking into some of the textures and the actual terrain generation and making it the whole terrain on the airfield map was kind of out of whack, and it didn't really fit the system we're using. So I have to have there's a lot of changes I have to make on that map to make it work well with the automated system. But that's the map that I'm currently like taking apart and assembling again, and hopefully as soon as possible, because I really like to be able to move on to some of the other maps as well and fix some more bugs. But the airfield map is the one I've been hammering on that for the last few weeks before the holidays. Flakpanzer is asking, you guys made armor 2.0 that made armor plates, but then the AT anti-tank gear got buffed and bypasses the armor. Will you nerf the anti-tank gear again? No, I don't think we will. Why should we do that? I don't think we should nerf that, the anti-tank gear. And there's Exator is asking, any plans for 2020 factions, classes, North Africa campaign? I can't say anything about that. Sorry. Marv 2.1 is asking, any chances there is an RTS air warfare upgrade coming? Well, again, the refactor needs to be in place on live first, and then we can start to look at what parts of the RTS are we going to upgrade. Personally, I would like to get the air warfare working as soon as possible, because that actually opens up to a lot of new interesting units that we can put into the game. But so there's a lot of other suggestions for the RTS game. Then there's Homo erectus asking, why would you call yourself Homo erectus? You're not a Homo sapien or what? Can you add more incentives for war? Everyone just grinds credits and staged. Well, you actually get a lot more XP for fighting war games anyway, so there is incentive. There might not be enough, we could take a look at that, but you do get it. It is more rewarding to fight the war battles. Then there's Italian AVI. Can you add another factions? Why does it say 150/5,000? Can you add other factions like English, the Italians, the French, the Japanese in war? Even these factions participated during the Second World War with their weapons and vehicles. Yes, it's been a long time wish for us to be able to add new factions. Fortunately, we have plenty of other things that are more important to do first. And again, if you start to add the new factions, they will be added probably as one class at a time with one very limited equipment, simply to get the ball rolling. Yeah, let's see. FM HNG is asking, can you add a weekend knife contest? I can ask if the guys want to make another event just with knives. Achillea 229 is asking, how will work the soldier specialization? The first iteration of the soldier specialization that we're currently working on is merely a system that will show players what is possible in the game for the different classes. So because the game is very open-ended in the equipment system, where you can actually mix and match a lot of different things in order to create a soldier that fits certain roles. So what we've done with the specialization is that we try to describe certain roles. For example, the good example would be a medic. If you want to play a medic, you need this equipment. And that's basically what it is at the moment. It just shows you how close you are to becoming a certain level of medic that we think you we should think you should be. And next iteration could be to enable you to actually lock your soldier into that specific role and give you some advantages. That could be medic equipment takes less equipment points and other equipment takes more equipment points, so you can actually have more medic pouches on you or whatever. A machine gunner could carry more ammunition and la la la, all those different things. So locking the soldier into a specific role could be the next iteration. But right now it's actually just open and just shows you how far you are from achieving a certain combination of items. Mini Pyok 98 says, when will we see women in the game? As soon as we make them. I know there's historically been some huge debate on how if we should add female characters or not to the game. I think that they fit perfectly well into the game. When we reach that point when we would like to start to add new characters, well, a female character would definitely fit the game. Can't say when then, because so that didn't really answer your question. Let's see. There's the Senos Cake says, please reduce the rivers in upcoming maps. Not fair advantage to defenders. The fortress map is not tweaked in place yet. There is obviously a lot of rivers, but there will be a lot of forts as well where you can cross the rivers to give a lot of flanking routes, and we might narrow down the distance as well. You're right. But right now the basic layout does actually have a lot of rivers on it, simply because that's how the historical layout was made. And there's ADM Polaras. I think he means infantry versus armor TTK varies too much from less than 1 second to almost 10, depending on the situation and target. Are you guys really okay with it being that fast? Will you ever consider alternate cameras or protect third person view to tanks now that they are back in a very killable state? Yeah, it's that's difficult to answer. We did make some changes to the anti-tank weapons and the armor, and we need to review if that is if that actually helps or it, if it's just too random right now. But again, I'm looking into this as soon as people are back from the vacation. I'm going to. I can see the time is 30. So I'm just going to take one more question, and then we're going to end the stream. I'm not going to take that map editor one. Battle Royale, when? Jesus Christ. let me see if I can find something that's... Fubar Red is asking, are you guys willing to work and slash cooperate with streamers to further the popularity and increase the interest in the game again? And if yes, when are you guys going to start cooperating and in what form? That's a bit of a lot of questions, but yes, we would like to work with streamers, and I'll obviously I should get back to you, or I should ask some of our community guys to get back to you to see if we can work something out. Yep. Okay, this was a bit of a, maybe for some, a bit of a little bit of a boring stream this time around, but we felt that we should stream something anyway, even though half the office is empty and there's nobody here. And so thanks for listening in, and thanks for the questions, good questions, and we'll see you guys next Friday, hopefully, and also on the battlefield.